Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. At the very beginning, I just want to mention that today is going to start the so-called Hive Fest. This is the annual gathering or fest of the Hive community, and they talk about the achievements and the new ideas to implement in the Hive community relating to Hive blockchain, to the different dApps, and etc. So this is really a very interesting event, and I will participate in this event because I've been participating in all Hive Fest since 2018, and I'm a really active member of this Hive community. And that's why, because today the Hive Fest will start, let's analyze today the price chart of Hive. So today I will talk about the price chart of Hive. Of course, we will start from the monthly time frame, but initially let me remove all these unnecessary elements from the chart. Here the price is 80 cents 0.20. so this is the monthly chart. We are to some extent very familiar with the price chart of Hive. We had a solid price increase earlier this year. After that, the price experienced decline, then the price rebounded in the middle of the summer, and now the price is increasing. This is the previous monthly candlestick, or for the month of October. We see that it has the highest closing price, so I've been talking about this, and we mark this as a solid bullish signal, indicating that slowly but steadily, probably the bulls are taking control over the market. Now let's get back to the candlestick chart. And the recent candlesticks, they have ascending local low, so this is also a bullish signal. Of course, these candlesticks, they have ascending local highs as well, so this is another bullish signal. However, this is the current candlestick for the current month, and we are close to the middle of the month. We see that it's a small candlestick with a tall upper shadow. So actually, I would say that because we are in the upper part of the body of the previous one, this candlestick indicates that the market is consolidating. But we have to keep in mind that all these candlesticks here, they have tall upper shadows. So this means that within this range, the bulls face a lot of resistance from the bears. So there are a lot of buyers here. It seems that when the price goes above 80 cents, many people start to sell, and they put a lot of pressure on the price. That's why these candlesticks here, they have this tall upper shadow. So definitely we have some small bullish signal, I would say, according to the recent candlesticks. But the bulls have to be really very careful because there is a lot of bearish pressure within this range. Now, according to the recent candlestick, the price is just consolidating, or it can, or actually the bulls cannot push the price further up because there is a lot of bearish pressure. This is in the monthly chart. Now let's switch to the weekly chart. Okay, this is the weekly chart, the price increase that took place earlier this year, followed by a decline, then the rebound started. Here we had this bullish engulfing, and now we have this uptrend renewal. However, if we have a look at the last part of the chart, here we have a lot of small candlesticks, and this means that the price is consolidating, and all these candlesticks, they have tall upper shadow. So this confirms that when the price goes above 80 cents, the bears start to sell and they put pressure on the price. So this just confirms that there is a lot of bearish pressure, and that's why the price cannot easily continue its upward movement. So we have to be really very careful. But here, let me switch to a linear chart. And I would remind you that we've been talking here since the beginning of September, probably about this cup and handle candlestick pattern. So this is the cup, this is the handle, and this is the upper part of the cup and handle. Let's assume that we have tea or coffee in this cup. So I would like to mention that it's a common bullish technical formation. So if the price surpasses, let's say, the upper part of this cup and handle technical pattern and remains above this threshold, let's say, then probably the uptrend will resume and this will mark the beginning of a solid and a reliable price increase or uptrend. But now we're still at this critical point. That's why it's better to continue to monitor the price, just remain in wait and see mode and wait for a bullish signal. That's it about the price chart in the weekly chart. Now let's switch to the candlestick chart. Let's go to the daily chart, but here let me remove all these elements from the price chart. Okay, this is the daily chart. This is the daily chart actually. I would like to mention that here, if we switch to a linear chart in the daily time frame, we have another cup and handle. So this is another cup and handle. This is the cup, this is the handle. So in the daily chart, the situation is very similar. We are at this critical point. It's a bullish technical pattern once again, but we still don't have a breakout. The price is at this critical line. So we need a bullish signal. We have to see the price steadily outside this cup and handle, or of course above the upper line of this cup and handle. And if we see that the price surpasses this critical line and remains above it, then we will receive a bullish signal. At the moment we don't have this bullish signal, but let's cross our fingers and hope that sooner or later it will occur. Now let me remove these elements from the chart. And I want to say that because we're in the daily chart, I will add the three key moving averages. So let's see what they say to us, the three key moving averages. So the first one is the 30-day moving average, or for the period of 1 month. The second one is for the period of 90 days, or 3 months, or one quarter. And the last but not least is the moving average for 360 days or 1 year. So these are the three key moving averages. So first of all, we see that we have all three moving averages probably are heading upwards. So this is a bullish signal. Of course, the first one at the moment is consolidating, moving sideways. And as we see, the price is at this 30-day moving average, consolidating, and definitely it is a support level, I would say, for the price. But it's obvious that also we have a bullish distribution of these moving averages, because the 30-day moving average is at the top, in the middle is the 90-day moving average, and at the bottom is the 1 year moving average. So definitely we have some bullish signals according to these moving averages, and let's hope that after some period of consolidation at the 30-day moving average, the price will receive enough support and rebound and resume the price increase. So this is according to the daily chart. Now let's remove these moving averages and check the 4-hour chart. Okay, this is the 4-hour chart. Here we had this price increase. After that, the price consolidated, or actually I would say experienced some kind of correction. Then the price tried to resume the uptrend after exiting this consolidation or correction, but unsuccessfully, because the price has returned to the area of this consolidation once again, and we're still in this consolidation range. So in the 4-hour chart, I don't see any clear bullish signal, because it's obvious that the price is consolidating. But keeping in mind that we had this price increase before the consolidation, it's highly probable that sooner or later, when the price exits the consolidation, that it will exit the consolidation in the upward direction in order to continue the previous, let's say, trend. So that's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view on the price chart of Hive as a comment below. I hope to see you at the Hive Fest later today. it will be in the virtual reality. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day, good luck in the financial markets, and I hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.